Resolute Bay is a tiny Inuit community tucked in a shallow gravelly bay along the northernmost leg of the Northwest Passage. It is Canada's second northernmost community.
So replace everything that you know about Canada with barren nothingness stretching in every direction. It's not how we imagine our Canada, but it is our backyard. Although we share this country with the people who live there, we will likely never visit that far north, and they will never get the opportunity to experience anything outside of that in their lifetime. The disparity between 24-hour darkness in winter and 24-hour daylight in summer is not one many of us would be able to fathom, but the Inuit people live, survive, and at times thrive in this bi-seasonal place they call home.
There are so many things we take for granted, from something as simple as the grass in our front yards to having 24 access to food at a price that is affordable. The ability to feed not only ourselves, but our families and our children. That is something we take as a right as Canadians, and these are things that are not always granted to the communities in the Arctic.
Taking a closer look at Canada as a whole reveals a huge disparity within the country. Nunavut has extremely high numbers of alcohol use, drug use, poverty, famine, dropout rates, teen pregnancy, child sexual abuse, and perhaps the most startling of all, suicide.
With the knowledge of what is going on up north, Innervation North's goal is to create opportunity and to ensure exposure for the youth of Resolute Bay. We believe that it is not the ability that is limiting, but the opportunity to do so.
We hope to implement education for these kids in the form of meditation, exploration, and artistic expression through workshops and team-building exercises. We hope to encourage personal growth and community involvement on a local and national level with two modules.
The first module of this mentorship program would take place in Nunavut. We would travel to the hamlet of Resolute Bay for approximately 3 weeks to promote self-worth and initiative. We would focus on paving the path towards positive mental activity and developing coping skills through art, meditation, and exercise. We want to encourage awareness of core values, personal interests, and offer guidance to these kids who don't get access to positive resources outside of their limited community. We anticipate to incorporate workshops with the elders to implement their knowledge and pass that down. It's important for the youth to recognize that not only is their culture very valuable to us and to them, but it's worth getting excited about and to keep those traditions alive. We hope to offer guidance and start a conversation regarding the negative impacts of isolation.
For the second module, we hope to bring 6 individuals back to Vancouver with us. Here they would get to experience the possibilities the rest of the world has to offer and take a step further in realizing their own potential. In Vancouver, we would plan hikes, overnight camping trips, museum visits, and university tours. Since these kids grew up above the tree line, they've never gotten the opportunity to even see a tree. We are firm believers that nature can heal and are excited to be able to share that with the kids. Once the program is finished, in turn, these youth can bring their experiences back and share this positivity with their peers.
The whole point of Innervation North is to address the social issues of the Arctic by starting at the root with the kids. We want to teach them ways to deal with their emotions in a proactive way and make them feel valuable. The ability to thrive is built into each of us, and we want to prove that to them.
Why us? Initially, we had come together with the goal of running a holistic summer program for youth. Upon proposing this and discussing the possibilities to people we know living and working intimately with the communities in the north, we discovered this caliber of program was greatly desired and needed in Resolute Bay. With our diverse range of skills and experiences, we believe that we can offer the kids a program that will not only improve their psychosocial health, but inspire them as well. This is not a short-term investment for us. We hope to continue to work in the North on an ongoing basis following this pilot. We are committed to creating interconnectedness within the reaches of Canada's vast borders and merging traditional and modern ideologies. The budget covers food for the camp, lodging, flights, and some supplies for art projects. To put it into perspective, a return trip alone for one person costs about $9,000 in itself. In order to make sure this program comes into fruition because of such high costs, we want to utilize the resources that are readily available to them, which would also expand their knowledge of how to use what they already have. Our intention with this program is that the positive impact be sustainable in the long term.
Innervation North wants to create an alliance, not only within that community, but within all of Canada.
We are pouring our hearts and time into this project because we truly believe it is a worthwhile and important cause.
If any of this has resonated with you, we are seeking funding.
If you're able to donate 5,
$50 or $100 to help make Innervation North a reality, it would be an investment not only in the youth of Resolute Bay, but in the future of our nation.
Thank you.
Thank you.